Howdy, Heroes Hearth. This is Kyle Ferguson from Into the Nexus podcast, and I'm here today to blow the lid on Samuro. Samuro counters how to hold back the fifth highest win rate hero in the video game. And diving straight in, the first counter we need to talk about in the solo lane is Sonya. Sonya brings an AoE heal as well. Oh, Sonya's not a counter. She's just a hard lane matchup. Well, what you really want to do is have a stacking quest as well as a global, and Falstad brings both of those, able to farm off of those illusions since they count as real here. Samuro only has a 69% win rate against Falstad. Counter, indeed. Big sarcasm. Well, that's just one quest. What about all the quests? And get them done against Sammy when he isn't paying attention to his... The sheer amount of ignorance in this comment is just amazing. Well, we're just not thinking big enough. After all, every illusion counts as a hero, so let's put a hero like Kel'Thuzad in that lane, and he'll get all his quests done very, very early. I mean, it's a free stacks forehead, just to instantly die to him anyway. Well, there's this great hero named Deathwing, who's very powerful, and brings in his Incinerate build, Self-Heal, and when it's hitting every illusion, this can allow you to... for Samuro to I-frame the W entirely, which makes the W not hit anything, and as such does not trigger a lot of the needed talents. Okay, so it's not about quests, and it's not about regeneration. It's about dodging, evading the attacks. If you can avoid Samuro's basic attacks, you'll win the matchup. Like what Kira has at level 4 with Upstage. She's not a counter, she can't stop Samuro from killing his chosen target. Okay, no problem. What about Illidan? Illidan's evading all the time. A beautiful easy win for Samuro, nope, intensifies. Illidan also becomes one of the single biggest jokes in lanes if Samuro decides to pick up Deflection. But it's not about evasion, it's about armor, physical armor, to negate the attacks. Like what Block Party brings on ETC. You can give your whole team physical armor. Not really, Block isn't very useful against high AA attack speed heroes like Samuro. That's okay, I got the perfect lane hero for it. Yarel. You got Dauntless after all. I mean, negates... Dauntless loses the offlane to Samuro, and only in teamfights if Samuro is actually hitting her, which he won't ever do. Let's restart the video. Howdy, Heroes Hearth. This is Kyle Ferguson from Into the Nexus podcast, and today we're going to talk about Samuro, who has no true counters, only misplays in low ranks. In fact, Samuro is an offlane flanker who takes a village to actually counter. If you don't want to be a part of somebody's next right-click compilation video, well then you better pay attention. So let's talk about what Sammy does, and then we'll get into what he wants, and then we can work back around to what counters him. So Sammy has Mirror Image, allows him to teleport a short distance in the direction of mouse cursor, creating two mirror images in kind of a triangle formation. And because of that mouse cursor bit, when Sammy splits with Mirror Image, we have no way to tell which one is the real Sammy. If the mouse is forward, our forward Sammy is the real Sammy. If the mouse is back, our back Sammy. And as such, back and forth, back and forth. We could tell a little bit maybe which way he went, but in the heat of battle, you're not going to be able to read this. There are some body language cues you could take from this. In fact, a lesser Sammy might delay a little bit in his movement. Many high league Sammies act like their mirror images and might move in silly ways, in very straight lines as soon as splitting, to make sure that they're not giving away the gig. The next part we need to acknowledge is that these images have their duration increased each time they or Samuro basic attack an enemy hero. Whenever an image takes damage, it deals that amount of damage to itself, effectively doubling the damage it takes. So, in the heat of battle, again, it's difficult to read, but illusions are going to take more damage than Sammy himself. Now, here's the big one. Using mirror images removes most negative effects from Samuro. This includes blinds, living bombs, drain hope, bone prisons, lightning rods from Falstad, slows, roots. Anything that can be self-cleansed off is going to be removed by this switcheroo. And in fact, it's also tied into his trait here, image transmission. Activate to switch places with target mirror image, removing most negative effects again. And as if that wasn't confusing enough, a self-cleanse, the ability to switch around with your illusions, we also have on top of this Windwalk, that grants Samuro stealth. While stealth, after the recent rework, Sammy is healing for maximum health every second. Movement speed is increased as well. And we have to acknowledge, Sammies are going to Sammy. The hero takes a lot of work to perfect. There is a lot of effort, even a personality type, that goes into learning Samuro. If you know a player on the enemy side, play Sammy, ban it. But otherwise, we're playing a bit of recovery to make sure the Sammy can't run full wild. In this case, we want to make sure we get rid of his good friend, Abathur, who is going to be hatting him, giving him range damage, shields, and everything else that can make this hero really sing when he's diving your backline. With the recent rise of Bloodlust, you may also want to consider banning Rhaegar. Bloodlust is running amok right now and makes for just very easy comps. What you're thinking here is more about removing the ease of execution, making the enemy team more difficult to play, and at the very least, making sure the support doesn't have a click-a-button win option for the Sammy. Predicting a Samuro outside of knowing a player name is extremely difficult. The popularity of this hero is only at 8% and only goes down from there. We are looking at absurdly high win rates on things like Towers of Doom, particularly following our recent Tower Anomaly. Illusions count as full heroes for aggro from those towers. On Towers of Doom, where you're able to transform an enemy fort into an allied fort, this is particularly powerful. There's lots of avenues, camps for Sammy to run around. Funnily enough, when we're thinking about Abathur maps, traditionally, Sky Temple and Cursed Hollow come to mind, though those are actually his lower win rates. And Sammies want to get in your head. They want to be frustrating, which is why they favor Illusion Master. Mirror images can be controlled individually or as a group, and their damage is increased by 100%. This also takes that image transmission's cooldown to 8 seconds. And this is where, if you're talking to Sammy players, you can feel like you're arguing with that nuh-uh kid on the playground. It's true, they don't have any hard counters. If they're losing the solo lane, they'll go take a merc camp. They'll double soak. If they can't access the back line, they'll just go and push a lane and get a keep. You need to acknowledge that things are going really well when Sammies go Blade Storm. This causes them to spin around, gives them 25 armor, and deal damage to nearby enemies. The majority of Sammies take this to recover from a bad position. They use it for lane clear. On a 25 second cooldown, they go double soaking, spinning on the lane, and then wind walk over to the next lane at great speed. This can feel like that Asmodan, that Zagara, just pushing down your lanes. It can feel like it needs heavy addressing. But we need to acknowledge that we're already winning the team fights. Basically, Sammy, by taking Bladestorm, is acknowledging that they're not having the presence on the back line or getting the kills that they want to. And you also shouldn't be over disappointed when Sammy uses his Q to dodge a CC like a blind. Johanna, Cassia, and Lili are not high win rate heroes. They are not counters on their own. Blinding Sammy just means he'll split or use transmission to recover from that blind. But your team needs to acknowledge that they have forced the transmission. They have forced a Q, a self-cleanse. And during that time now available of 14 seconds or less, depending on heroic choice, we have options to CC and slow down Sammy's advance. This is why it takes a village. One CC is not going to cut it. Sammy is going to dodge and self-cleanse out. But if we all work together to manage Sammy, now it's getting interesting. The team has to be able to counter all these different Sammy playstyles. We need that global hero to deal with Sammy when he decides that he can't win team fights. We need that solo lane hero to make sure that Sammy can't win his solo lane. And as these various ideas come into Samuro players' heads, we need to make sure we have another hero ready to counter that. So when I say this is our best counter, realize that Sammy is going to disagree with me because he's not countered by anything, he'll just walk away. But we want to stop Sammy from doing his switcheroo. We want to stop the transmissions, we want to stop the cues. And silences are our number one way of doing this. Malfurion, Alarak can help protect that backline and give us a moment to react to Sammy. There are other silences in the game. It is difficult to pick out the correct target for a Valyra Garrote. It is quite difficult to stand still versus Sammy as Stukov. But you know what else Stukov has? A knockback. And knockbacks, like the one that Stukov has with Flailing Swipe, reset Sammy's illusions AI, meaning they have a chance to just fart off. Whatever commands they were issued on spawn, attacking one target specifically, they will reset. If Sammy is doing Illusion Master, they will have to re-click, readjust. But beyond that cute little fact, we are causing Sammy to miss his moment of engage. Possibly, a Stukov with a good eye here could reveal him, completely ruining his sweet moment to get right on top of the back line. We have other heroes like Brightwing. Lucio is phenomenal at this. His knockback is on a very short cooldown and very controllable. He can help peel for our squishy backline. What about Li Ming Wave of Force? Here's a hero with an amazing win rate against Sammy, Sergeant Hammer. Now, the first thing that Sammy's gonna say was, well, I would own Sergeant Hammer. I would do deflection at 4. This is a group effort. We are not making Sergeant Hammer solo nor be the only thing interacting with Sammy. The whole team is going to help Sergeant Hammer avoid the Sammy damage, but a knockback can cause those illusions to wander off and stop the moment of engage for Samuro. Rainer, squishy, oh no, he's got a self-heal, he's got a pushback. Together we can work with this. Yarel, helping peeling for the backline, pushing off Samuro. Chen doing a barrel, acting as the off tank. Now it's important to note here that we really can't trust the main tank to be doing this. While ETC has an amazing knockback with Face Melt, he's likely busy with the other 4 people on the enemy team. Does not have eyes for Sammy in the back. We need to make sure that we're taking care of the team in an off-tank way. Now you're all smart, I don't have to belabor this point, but let's do one more example. Here is a wide variety of heroes that maybe taking the solo lane might be working in that off-tank capacity. Either way, these are heroes that are going to take advantage of illusions. If there are more heroes in the area, Sonya will heal more off her Whirlwind. Leoric will heal more off his level 1 Consume Vitality talent. You know what Sammy says to these particular splashy multi-hit characters? Well, I simply won't split. I, as a good Sammy, as a masterful Sammy, will not activate my Q, thereby not allowing you to have the value of hitting multiple heroes. But as a village, as a team, we hit Sammy with the blind. We hit Sammy with a root, with a slow. We knock him out of stealth. You know what he wants to do to remove those CCs already on him? Split. Sammy's will tell you that none of these heroes are counters, but as a team, we can make them counters. What about something cute like Medivh Polybomb? Well, I certainly would never. I would never activate my Q going up against Medivh. Well, he's into the team. Why don't we activate our Polybomb once somebody else, like a Blinding Johanna, got Sammy to use transmission to hit their mirror images? You're not alone on the battlefield. We need to draft multiple answers to Sammy to make sure he's limited in what he can do. Once we get that initial blind, that initial knockback, that poke that ruins a stealthed engage, then every cute idea you have in the game can be viable. AoE damage, not only to reveal who might be the real Sammy, but to wither down the Sammies so all their various illusions will always be lower health. Sammy, when he pops Mirror Illusion, copies his health into the illusions around him. Dahaka deals AoE damage, gets resets on his Dark Swarm with talents, and can absolutely help reveal a true Sammy. Late game Mephisto is constantly triggering his trait, getting a lot of bolts to fire, a lot of lightnings cast, as well as able to reposition and dodge Sammy during that initial moment of engage. Q build Zeratul, getting resets, withering down the Sammy. Tyrael, able to spread shields to his allies, negating early engagements, maybe even sanctifying on top of that. Ariel, maybe a blind, maybe a whip, AoE damage with her sweep, as well as an ability to dodge the initial engage with Aegis. Rhaegar Lightning Shield build, now healing for big amounts surrounded by all those Sammies. Individually, none of these heroes are a counter. We all build a team together that makes Sammy useless. If you want to draft a more traditional mage when you're thinking about AoE damage to whittle down the illusions and Sammy himself, we don't want to think about Kael'thas. Kael'thas's living bombs are removed by Mirror Image, but also Flamestrike's delay explosion, with only a single explosion untalented, allows Sammy to use Mirror Image to not exist for a hot moment and dodge. What we want to think instead is something like Jaina, that has actual ground control, area control for an extended period of time with Blizzard. That will actually force Sammy out of an area. Gul'dan's Fel Flames are also quick enough that Sammy shouldn't be able to dodge them in most cases. And while we're talking about squishies here, use your World of Warcraft rules. Run to your tank. Don't run away. Sammy has movement speed with every auto attack, plus the wind walking. You're not going to escape from Sammy by running. You need to position yourself closer to the people who are going to heal you through the damage or peel for you. When you've succeeded at step one, locking Sammy out of the team fights, and he goes into split pushing, we don't really want to counter him with some of our usual soakers. Instead, we still want to use those counters we talked about earlier. Knockbacks, silences. These sort of heroes will actually threaten Sammy's life when he's split pushing like that, and still has the global to rejoin a team fight once you've handled the situation with the Sammy. Poison damage can also help force a Sammy to misplay or miscue, whittling down Sammy to make sure that his illusions aren't at full health during his next engage and his next switcheroo. And just like poisons, reveals can be another part of this puzzle. These can all be a part of that counter pie, or a layered cake that we're building to stop Sammy. I'm not going to belabor the point, so it's time to end this video. Don't let yourself be tilted by Sammies. They are always going to change their playstyle to match whatever pocket is available for them to fill. You are winning when they are soaking, in particular if they're using Bladestorm to do it. It takes your entire team to stagger your abilities. Getting Sammy to mirror image switch and transmission is its own reward. Realize that you're forcing a misplay anytime he does that. Don't leave your backline alone. The tank may be busy. Someone like Thrall, Zul, Urel, or even a support like Lucio might have to take up the mantle of off-tank to make sure that he's not running amok. Put the right hero in the right job. Make sure he's not stealing your camps with your camp hero. Make sure he's not pushing down your keep with your global hero. And make sure you have a strong solo lane that isn't going to allow him to own the beginning of the match and get that XP lead. And finally, don't listen to Sammies who say that your particular pick is not a counter pick. There's five people that they're fighting. It's not a 1v1 game. I was Kyle Ferguson. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell here at Heroes Hearth for more Learn to Play Heroes of the Storm videos. And a special thanks to Stark in this video for the help with all the Sammy tips.